Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning guys, how are you today?
Morning.
I'm fine too, alhamdulillah. Okay, before we start our lesson today, please the leader to lead the prayer together. Mas Dodo, please. Okay, thank you for Mas Dodo. And now, I'm going to checking attendance. Who is absent today?
No one.
Okay, good. Alhamdulillah. Now, before we start our lesson, I will ask to you. Have you ever see this?
Yes.
What is this?
Announcement.
Where you see the announcement?
In public.
In school.
Jalan.
Okay. Nah, okay. So, you ever been see the announcement? Now, the material today we are going to learn about announcement. Okay. Now I will share to you about the audio announcement. Please listen carefully and I will ask to you and you can answer my question.
Good morning, school. Please listen carefully to these announcements about school uniforms. It is important to respect the school uniform. Please remember, girls shouldn't wear trousers. All girls must wear a triple skirt, and you must wear white socks. You shouldn't wear black or gray socks. Boys can wear a pullover under their purple blazer. The pullover must be blue.
Okay, finish?
Finish.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay, now I will ask to you, what is the announcement about?
About school uniform.
Okay, good. Give applause to Mbak Dwi. And then, who is the announcement for? To all students, please answer. For?
All students.
Okay, good. And now, I will explain the material about announcement, and I will write in the blackboard because the PowerPoint are error. Okay, what is the purpose of announcement? To give important information to many people. Okay, now please. Now I will share the announcement to you to read together, yeah? Ini karena PPT-nya lama. Misalnya. Okay. Have you finished read the announcement?
Yes.
Okay. Now I will you to make a group. One group consists 3 or 4 people. Please make a group. Okay. Now I will share the answer sheet to you to assessment the announcement material. Okay, for the please listen carefully. For the number one, 5 number is essay and 5 number is multiple choice. 5 numbers is from the audio and 5 number from the text. Okay, the first audio.
Good afternoon, passengers. This is a pre-boarding announcement for flight 89B to Rome. We are now inviting those passengers with small children and any passengers requiring special assistance to begin boarding at this time. Please have your boarding pass and identification ready. Regular boarding will begin in approximately 10 minutes time. Thank you.
Okay. Butuh repeat gak?
Yes.
Okay. Once again, ya.
Those passengers with small children and any passengers requiring special assistance to begin boarding at this time.
Okay, this is the audio one and then the audio two. Please listen carefully.
October 3rd. All interested students from grades 7, 8, and 9 are invited. Once again,
there will be a meeting for the purpose of organizing the free club, which will be held in room 7 of the main building at 2 p.m. on Friday, October 3rd.
All interested students from
Okay, and now I will give you 10 minutes to answer the multiple choice. Have you finished, guys?
Yes.
Okay. Before you gathering the answer sheet, I will you to playing game. If I say black, you must find the noun that the color black and touch that. If you don't find that, you have punishment. Okay, ready?
Ready.
Okay. White.
White.
Okay. Now. Stand up, please. Stand up, please. Okay, stand up, please. Now, green. Please find noun have color green.
Green.
Okay. Mbak Dwi, you must get punishment. Please read the announcement.
Okay.
Okay, sit down.
Announcement to all employees. There will be a blackout on Saturday during this month. Consequently, we will use the generator as the electric source and blah blah blah.
Okay, thank you, Mbak Dwi.
Yes.
Before we are finished the lesson, what the purpose announcement?
Give important information.
Okay, good. Now, don't forget to find the announcement in the home and find the what the content of announcement and where the announcement can find. Okay, guys, do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Thank you so much for today, and don't forget to review the lesson. See you next time. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Dalam? 10. Tadi berapa menit, Mbak?
11.
Kamu stok singkat-singkat banget.
Tadi kalau udah 8 menit, pencet yang warna kuning ya?
Power off.
Peng, cek to peng.
Sabar.
Ya orang obor po.
Ora paham dilatih-latih.
Ya oke. Ora ya. Ki.
Sini lo. Ini gak kok lo.
Ih sumpah.
Hah. Itu jangan pakai kok berita era ya. Dwi please Mas Yumi.
Oh my god.
Ki nyunggi.
Apa? Wish deskriptif. Tutul nek ora juruk engko please maca ya.
Iya iya. Ngomong bae juruk lewat
nek apa. Santai di.
Tapi saya mau ngomong apa lagi. Cuma kok. Asik. Mantap. Mama tak. Deskriptif. Ini ada. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
How do you feel today?
Alhamdulillah.
Okay, alhamdulillah. Okay, before we start our lesson today, please the leader of the class to lead our prayer. And I will check your attendance. Who is absent today?
No one.
Alhamdulillah. Okay. Yesterday I already tell you about the material that we will learn today. Anyone can remember what the material today? Please raise your hand. Yes, good, Mas Zuhra. It's about descriptive text. And before we go to the material. I have a game. The game is tebak gambar. And the rules is one of the students come to the front of the class to guess the picture, and each other student gives one clue. Please do not say the name of the picture. I will share the picture in the PowerPoint. Please, anyone will be the guest. And each other students will give one clue. Nanti berurutan ya, memberi cluenya. Can we start now?
Yes.
Okay. This is the picture. Jangan lihat. Okay, let's start the game from Basuro. Next, Mas Salsa.
He has small eyes and he is tall and thin.
Okay, next, Mas Asip.
It's president.
Can you? Who is he?
No pain.
Oh, bukan. Jokowi.
Jokowi.
Yes, very good. He is Mr. Joko Widodo. Okay. Now, please, one of the students read the example of descriptive text in the PowerPoint. Please. Okay.
My best friend.
Okay, thank you, Mas Asip. This is the example of descriptive text about person. So, descriptive text is text that describes someone, something, or place. And now we will learn about descriptive text about person or someone. And the social function of descriptive text is to describe a particular person, place, or thing. And the structure of descriptive text, there are identification and also description. And the last is about language features, is using adjective and using simple present. And the structure of descriptive text is identification and description. In the identification, contents about the introduction of a person, place, animal, or object will be described. And in the description, contains description of person by describing its features, forms, colors, or anything related to what the writer described. And the language features that used in the descriptive text is adjectives. For example, adjectives is beautiful, smart, short, humble, and etc. Okay? Do you have any questions so far, guys?
No.
No. Okay. Okay, for the last, I have an assessment for you. Please do the assessment in the paper, yeah. If you have done, please collect to me. I will give you 15 minutes. Is it enough, guys?
Nah.
Okay. Do you have done?
Done.
Okay, I will collect your answer. Okay. And now we go to the end of the class. What we learned today? It's about descriptive text. And in the descriptive text, there are definition, social function, structure, and also language features. Okay. For the next material, it's about descriptive text about animal. Please dipelajari dulu di rumah. Besok kita tinggal mempelajari materinya lebih lanjut. And I think our time is up. Let's close this class by saying hamdalah together. Thank you and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Gua belum mampu.
Pakai ini, Bang. Perang ngomong. Ini orang ke berisi? Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. How are you
guys?
Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, masyaallah tabarakallah. I have a good day today and let's start our class by saying basmalah together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, who is absent today? Sounds good. So today we learn about narrative text, and before we move to the material, first watch this video. Okay, I think enough. So, jadi apa yang dimaksud oleh video tersebut? Jadi video ini kan bercerita tadi seorang putri, putri yang ada di suatu kerajaan yang jauh di sana. Nah, kira-kira kalau putri yang berada di kerajaan yang jauh di sana, lalu biasanya dianimasikan dengan kartun, termasuk dengan salah satu jenis? Nah, betul, dongeng. Jadi pada hari ini kita akan belajar banyak tentang dongeng, karena dongeng merupakan salah satu bentuk dari narrative text. Nah, pada hari ini kita akan belajar narrative text terkhusus untuk bagian fairy tales atau dongeng. Nah, untuk learning objective pada hari ini, yang pertama, students will be able to identify the social function. The second, student will be able to identify the structure. The third, student will be able to identify the language feature. And the last, student will be able to get specific information from narrative text. So, we move to the material. First, is definition. Nah, tadi kan kita sudah lihat video. Nah, kira-kira definisi dari narrative text itu apa? Tadi kan saya sudah menampilkan narrative text berupa video dongeng. Jadi naratif teks adalah
teks yang menceritakan
tentang apa? Tentang apa, Mbak Dewi?
Dongeng.
Nah,
fiktif.
Hampir benar. Jadi pada intinya naratif teks itu adalah cerita fiktif yang kira-kiranya itu bertujuan untuk menghibur penonton. Jadi menghibur pembaca. Jadi memang naratif teks itu bukan diambil dari kejadian nyata, namun diambil dari karangan atau halusinasi dari penulis, dari author, yang bertujuan untuk menghibur, to entertain the reader. Nah, di sini saya punya salah satu bentuk teks naratif. Judulnya Snow White. Silakan, saya kasih waktu 5 menit untuk Snow White. Judulnya Snow White. Silakan dibaca dulu. Kalau bisa sambil dianalisis, nanti akan saya tanya. masalah. Karena nanti kita akan membahas yang pertama karena tadi sudah definition, lalu kita akan membahas selanjutnya ada social function, kita akan membahas structure, lalu kita akan membahas language feature. Silakan diamati dan dibaca dalam waktu 2 menit.
Finish.
Okay, good, but we finish. Okay, after this, we talk about structure. Nah, structure pada narrative text itu yang pertama ada orientation, yang kedua ada complication, yang ketiga ada resolution, yang keempat ada coda. Nah, setiap cerita pasti ada
awalan.
Nah, bagus Mas Nasib. Jadi awalan itu disebut sebagai orientation atau orientasi dari suatu cerita terlebih pada teks naratif. Jadi awalan atau pendahuluan pada narrative text itu disebut dengan orientation. Lalu selanjutnya, ketika sudah ada awalan, biasanya dalam satu cerita, apalagi terlebih lagi sinetron-sinetron yang di Indonesia itu pasti akan ada
masalah.
Nah, bagus, Mas Arsa. Jadi setiap ada awalan pada cerita pasti ada suatu masalah di dalamnya. Nah, masalah pada teks naratif it's called by complication. Jadi complication itu bagian yang paling panjang dari teks naratif dan berisi masalah-masalah mulai dari awal masalah sampai ke titik klimaks atau titik masalah paling tinggi dari teks naratif. Nah, biasanya setelah ada masalah pasti ada. Nah, bagus Mas Ib. Jadi setelah ada masalah akan ada namanya penyelesaian, ya, bukan baku hantam. Jadi penyelesaian masalah pada teks naratif disebut dengan resolution. Nah, pada bagian resolution ini nanti mulai akan terlihat akhir dari cerita teks naratif pada dongeng, teks naratif yang bersifat berjenis dongeng, apakah itu nanti happy ending or sad ending, itu akan terlihat pada bagian resolution. Nah, selanjutnya ada bagian coda. Coda sering juga dengan bagian resolution. Jadi pada coda ini author menyampaikan pesan moral apa yang ingin author sampaikan ke reader. Jadi mungkin teks seperti Snow White itu nanti bercerita tentang apa, lalu positif moral value yang bisa diambil dari teks tersebut itu apa, seperti itu. Nah, kita akan membahas language feature. Nah, berdasarkan teks tadi ini kira-kira apa grammar apa yang ada di teks ini, karena kan kita tahu grammar adalah salah satu bentuk dari language feature. Nah, grammar apa yang ada di teks ini? Nah, untuk language feature-nya yang ada di yang ada di narrative text, yang pertama itu using simple past tense. Benar tadi Mas Asif, pertama using simple past tense, yang kedua using of adverb of time, yang ketiga using time conjunction, yang keempat use specific character or not in general, 5 using action verb, and 6 using direct speech. So after we to the material, okay, let's do the exercise one. Nah, untuk exercise one di sini saya akan sangat melakukan memberikan teks reading pada kalian. Silakan dikasih waktu. Okay, good. So we discuss the material. Question one, what is purpose of the text? Okay, the second, why did Snow White live with her uncle? Where did Snow White parent? Okay, how many drops that live with Snow White? And what is the moral lesson of the story? Okay. Now we move to the listening task. So please make a group consist three students. Okay, please grup grupnya Mbak Dewi silakan maju ke depan. Mbak Dewi saja. Ya. Nah, Mbak Dewi silakan dipilih antara merah, kuning, hijau di depan. Warna apa, Mbak Dewi?
Hijau.
Hijau, silakan dibuka. Dibuka. Pertanyaannya apa?
What type of the text?
Oke. Okay. Nah, silakan dilihat. Nah, ini teksnya tipenya apa? Enough, Mbak Dewi?
Enough.
Oke. Okay. Tipenya apa?
Narrative.
Good, Mbak Dewi. So, we move to the conclusion. Today, we will learn about?
Narrative.
Oke. Okay. And for the evaluation today, please do the exercise in LKS. Silakan kerjakan penilaian siswa pada lembar kerja siswa bagian narrative text. Nah, for the next material, we will learn about imperative sentence. Any question? Okay, I think enough. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Berapa menit, Mbak? 10 menit pas? Udah. Berapa menit waktunya? 10.
Cepet deh. Ya, cepet pol, sumpah.
Sumpah ngomong gue panter kue, nyong tinggal ya nyong gue panter kuat deh. Eh sih, kan sih orang kegawa. Ya gue gue liatin yang kono. Ngono terus ke, kita tengok rekaman. Bisa guys, bisa ngonmu, Masya Allah.
Bukan aku rekam anak video ini soalnya,
aku bakal video ini sih. Oke, di sini, ini belajar ini sih.
Ngomongin video gue maksudnya. Oke. Okay. Aku masih masa kayak
yuk cuma ini
oke, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning everyone.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm
fine to thank you. Have you ready to study now?
Yes.
Okay, before we start our lesson today, it will be better if we praying together. For the leader of the class, Mas Azib, please lead the praying. Okay, everyone, do you know what will we learn today? No?
No.
Okay, today we will learn about asking and giving opinion. So what will we learn today? Asking and giving opinion. Before we study further about that, I have a video to you, so please keep your attention on the video. Okay, finish guys.
Finish.
Yes, so this is an example of expression of asking and giving opinions. So do you know what the expression of asking opinion about this conversation? What the types of expression of asking opinion? From conversation Anna and Sabila, what the asking opinion? Yang mana? Asking is
what do you think
about my dress? Okay, good. And for giving opinion, yang mana? From conversation Anna and Sabila. Is yes, that's cute. I think your dress is so beautiful. It is a expression of giving opinion. So I want you to make some groups. The group consists two members. I want Mas Azib and Mas Dodo to be group one, and Mbak Suro and Mbak Dwi group two, Mbak Irma and Mbak Ade group three, and Mbak Laila and Mbak Ade is group four. And from the first practice, I want you to get this and this and this and this. Okay, have you get?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, I want you to analyze with your partner about what to example of asking and what the example of giving opinion. Are you understand?
Yes, yes, yes.
So what will we do guys? Okay, we would like to analyzing and fill in the blank about what is the asking and giving opinion. Okay, I will give you 5 minutes. It is enough?
No.
Okay, 5 minutes start from now. Have you finished?
Finish.
Okay, you finished? Please collect to me. Yes, okay, thank you. And Mbak Laila. Okay, thank you. And Mas Azib. Okay, thank you. So, yes, so guys, asking opinion is used when you want to have any question or ask opinion from anyone else. So asking, what is asking in Indonesia? Asking is meminta, and opinion is
pendapat.
Yes, of course. And then giving opinion, what is giving in Indonesia? Okay, good. So giving opinion we use before we give our opinion. It will be better if start with expression of giving opinion. And this is example of asking and giving opinion. Like from asking, like what do you think about, what is your opinion about, what or how about, and so on. And from giving opinion, like I think, I personally think, in my opinion, I feel, and so on. Okay, I think you have to understand about this topic. So I need you with your group member to make a dialogue. But wait. I have some roles. So please from group 1, from Mas Azib and Mas Dodo. Please choose one. Okay. And then Mas Zuhro, choose one. And then, okay. Udah dapat semuanya? Okay. I need you to make a dialogue, and the content after all is the theme of the dialogue that you want to make. Jadi, lintingan itu adalah tema dari dialog yang harus kalian buat, seperti itu. Paham? Okay, any question?
No.
So what will we do, guys?
Yes.
We need to make a dialogue, yes, with your group. Consists 10 sentences. Yes, 10 sentences. I will give you 20 minutes. It is enough?
Yes.
Enough, okay. 20 minutes start from now.
Finish?
Okay. I need you to present your result of your dialogue. What? Siapa yang mau maju pertama? Yes, Mbak Dwi and Mbak Zuhro. Okay, please present your result of the dialogue.
Hi, can I ask you something?
Of course.
I need your opinion about my painting. Do you think it's good enough?
Well, I think your painting is beautiful. Did you paint it by yourself?
Of course. Do you think my painting is not too much?
No, I really like your painting, especially the colors.
Thank you. Your opinion means a lot to me.
Thank you.
Okay, give a applause for Mbak Dwi and Mbak Zuhro. Yes, let's move to conclusion, guys. What will we learn today? What have we learned today?
About
asking and giving opinion. So what the example of asking opinion? And
what is your?
Yes, that's good. And for giving opinion? And then? Yes, so good. Okay guys, I think enough for me. And wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Thank you.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning class, how are you today? I'm fine too, thank you. Okay, before we start our lesson today, please the chairman lead your class to pray together. Okay, Bazuro. Okay, thank you, Bazuro, for leading the class to pray together. Now I'm gonna check your attendance list. Who is absent today?
No one,
so no one is absent today, so yes. We can start our lesson together. So let's start by saying basmalah together.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim.
Okay, so do you know what we're gonna learn today?
No.
Okay, so I'm gonna give you a text. yeah, this is a text. Who wants to read it?
Last one.
Okay, Mas Noval, please read it.
Last one, I was at my house with my mother. We were relaxing and wanted to read a book. When I want to start reading a novel, can't find my reading glass. I tried looking for it in my bedroom, under my bed, in the bathroom, but I couldn't find it anywhere after
all. Okay, thank you, Mas Noval, for reading the text. What do you think about the text?
Baca buku.
Nice. It's betul, hampir betul. Cuma ini adalah teks mengenai pengalaman pribadi di masa yang sudah lampau. Kalian tahu nggak apa itu namanya? Kalau pengalaman pribadi ditulis sebagai teks itu namanya apa?
Berita.
Oh ya, betul sekali. Hari ini kita akan belajar mengenai recount text. Jadi kalau kalian mempunyai pengalaman pribadi terus dituangkan dalam tulisan lalu apa ya, ditulis secara sistematis, itu namanya adalah recount text. So I have another text here. Maybe Mas Slamet want to read it? Please read it, Mas Slamet.
Last week, my family and I had picnic.
Okay, finished. Thank you, Mas Slamet. And today we're going to analyze this text. Okay, so there are four parts of this text. Ada empat bagian, ada empat paragraf dari teks ini. Menurut kalian, yang pertama itu adalah apa?
Orientation.
Siapa yang bilang tadi? Si pintar. Ya, yang pertama itu adalah orientation. Lalu yang kedua adalah? Yang paragraf, bagian paragraf yang kedua adalah? Lebih keras lagi?
Event.
Oh, nah, pintar. Lalu yang ketiga adalah?
Reorientation. Resolution.
Enggak, masih sama ya. Di paragraf ketiga masih event. Nah, baru yang terakhir itu baru reorientation. Betul sekali. Nah, jadi setelah melihat apa teks ini, menurut kalian apa itu recount text? Apa itu recount text?
Text which retells events or experiences in the past.
Bisa diulangi?
Text which retells
detail
events or experiences in the past.
Event or experiences in the past. Betul sekali. Tepuk tangan buat Mbak Andes. Lalu dari teks tadi, menurut kalian apa sih? Apa fungsinya dari recount text?
To retell events.
Betul. Betul. Lalu kita langsung masuk ke generic structure. Ya, seperti yang tadi Mbak Zuhro dan Mbak Irma sebutkan, ada tiga ya. Yang pertama adalah orientation, di mana di orientation itu introducing the participant, place and time. Yang kedua ada times, yang kedua ada events, yaitu describing series of events that happened in the past. Yang ketiga lalu, yang terakhir reorientation. Lalu kita masuk ke language feature. Ya, dalam recount text, ada beberapa language feature yang terkandung ya. Yang pertama ada mengandung introducing personal participant, yaitu I, my, my group, atau dan yang lainnya. Lalu menggunakan chronological connection, then first, dan sebagainya. Terus ada menggunakan simple past tense. Lalu di sini saya punya apa? Semacam latihan soal. Nih, coba dibaca. Saya kasih waktu 2 menit ya. Sudah. Nah, dari cerita di sini, where did the dialogue take place?
Airport.
On the plane. Betul. Terus pertanyaan yang kedua, was Anang a talkative boy?
Yes.
Betul, yes he was. And then why did Anang ask many things on the plane?
It was the first flight for him.
Nice, pinter sekali. Lalu kita punya games. Gamesnya simple ya.
Yeah.
Jadi saya akan membagi kalian ke dalam dua grup. Saya punya dua kertas berisikan recount text yang acak, nanti kalian harus menyusunnya. Oke, okay? Grupnya dibagi ya, cowok sama cewek ya. Oke, okay, seperti itu. Nah, ini silakan. This is Mas Dodo. Oke, okay, finish. Mas Dodo, please read it. Yeah, for your.
Yesterday was a great sunny day. I went to the zoo, a place with lots of animals. I went there with my friend and my teacher, Mr. James.
Okay, you finished, Mas Dodo?
A lot of animals there at the zoo. Finished.
Okay, thank you, Mas Dodo. Give applause to Mas Dodo, it's right. And then, after that, we have finally assessment. So, I have a paper here, and I'm going to give it to you one by one. So you need to answer it. It's a ABCD question. So you need to answer it, and then after that, after you finish, you will collect it back to me. All right? Are you understand, everyone?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. This is I'm going to give you one by one. I'm gonna give you 13 minutes. Is that enough? Okay. So start by now. You finish?
Finish.
All right. Let me collect it back. Oh. So that's the ending of our class. So, jadi ini untuk penilaian ya. Ada semua ini untuk penilaian, jadi jawaban yang benar akan masuk ke dalam penilaian. Nah, dari sini apa yang udah tadi kita pelajari?
Recount text.
Nah, benar sekali. Nah, di dalam recount text itu ada generic structure, ada berapa?
Tiga.
Apa saja? Nah, benar sekali. Terus setiap teks itu ada fungsinya, dan untuk recount text fungsinya itu apa?
Menceritakan.
Betul sekali, menceritakan pengalaman yang sudah lampau ya. Nah, karena kelas kita sudah habis, waktunya sudah selesai, saya akan memberikan tugas untuk membaca LKS untuk pertemuan minggu depan, yaitu materinya adalah narrative text. Oke, so let's end this class with hamdalah together. So, see you next time. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam
kayak aneh teman. Kepriwe. Anjir kutung. Kok tuh bisa pucarin? Oh iya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm fine. How about you?
Okay. Before we start our class today, let's pray together. Please, Chairman, pimpin doa, Mbak Zuhro.
Mulai.
Okay, thank you. Okay, siapa yang tidak berangkat hari ini?
No one.
No one. Alhamdulillah. Okay, we will discuss about procedure text. Before we start our material, I have picture. Do you know what this? Yeah. Ada apa aja?
Noodle.
Terus?
Orange juice. Iced tea.
Yeah. Yang noodle itu bahannya apa aja?
Mie.
Terus cara masaknya? Direbus. Yang lemon tea? What's the ingredients to make lemon tea?
Lemon
and? Okay. Nah, kenapa saya tanya tentang cara pembuatan dan bahan-bahannya? Karena kita akan membahas tentang procedure text. I have example about procedure text. This is about manual procedure text. Manual itu yang tentang cara memasak, cara membuat. Nah, di sini saya punya how to make mango juice. You can see that, right?
Yes, yes.
What's the ingredient? And then, okay. What's the step? Okay. Terus language feature-nya itu menggunakan simple past tense atau present tense?
Present tense.
Terus yang first, next, then itu termasuk kata apa?
Conjunction.
Nah, terus saya punya contoh yang membuat pencil box. Pencil box apa itu?
Tempat pensil.
Nah, kalau yang tadi itu kan ingredient. Nah, kalau yang membuat sesuatu itu ada material dan step. Material itu berarti apa?
Bahan-bahan.
Terus langsung saja ke materi procedure text. Procedure text itu apa? Procedure text is a text which aiming to inform the readers about the step to do something. Usually use the word how to make, and how to operate, gitu. Nah, text procedure itu ada dua. Yang pertama itu text procedure manual, dan yang kedua itu text procedure tips atau tentang penggunaan sesuatu. Terus, apa sih tujuan dari text procedure? Ada yang tahu?
To explain how to make something used or done through a sequence of steps.
Okay, great. Give applause to Mbak Zuro. Ya, tujuan dari text procedure itu to explain how to make or to do or use and done through a sequence of steps. Ya, secara jelas dan berurutan. And then the structure of procedure text ada berapa?
Three.
What is that?
Aim or goal.
And then? Okay, give applause for us. Ya, aim and goal itu maksudnya adalah tujuan. Apa sih tujuan dari teks yang dibuat itu? Tujuan itu biasanya terletak pada judulnya. How to make seblak misal. Terus ingredient atau material itu adalah menjelaskan bahan-bahan atau peralatannya. Kalau ingredient itu biasanya ada pada pembuatan
makanan.
Kalau material itu pembuatan rumah. Ya, rumah. Yang benda ya. Kalau step dan method itu adalah langkah-langkahnya. Iya. Terus language feature di procedure text itu menggunakan simple present tense. Kenapa? Karena itu menjelaskan tentang penggunaan. Kalau past tense agak aneh ya, ini enggak cocok. Contoh dari simple present tense itu apa? Misal do, write, kayak gitu ya. Terus imperative sentence, apa itu imperative sentence?
Kalimat perintah.
Ada contohnya, ada yang bisa?
Get, steal, eat, will.
Yes. Kalimat perintah itu biasanya diawali dengan verb atau kata kerja. Kata kerjanya itu bisa boil, stir, and get, add, gitu. Nah, contoh imperative sentence-nya itu add 5 spoons, add some milk, gitu. And then connective. Connective itu kata penghubung. Contohnya?
First,
second,
next, then.
Iya. Yeah. Itu biasanya ada di bagian ingredient atau apa?
Iya,
step, ya. Yeah. Give applause to Mbak Irma. And adverb of manner. Adverb of manner itu kata keterangan tentang? Tentang? Iya. Yeah. Slowly, fastly, kayak aduklah dengan? Lembut. Ya, dan pelan, gitu. Nah, itu termasuk adverb of manner. Berarti apa aja language feature? Ada simple?
Simple present tense, imperative sentence, subjective, adverb of manner.
Oke. And next. Nah, ini ada contoh tentang how to schedule Zoom meeting for an online class. Kalian udah pernah online class?
Sering.
Itu semester berapa?
Semester
4. Berarti sering menggunakan Zoom meeting ya?
Yes.
Nah, ini ada apa tuh? Tool. Terus instruction. Tools itu sama dengan?
Ingredient.
Kalau untuk membuat makanan. Nah, ini kalau untuk operate itu namanya tool dan instruction. Instruction itu biasanya kita lebih taunya step atau method. Coba dari teks ini yang termasuk conjunction mana?
Then, first.
Iya, betul. Terus imperative sentence?
Open.
Click. Oke,
click.
Great. You are very great today. Ya, di sini saya punya tugas buat grup minimal 4 orang. Nah, nanti ngerjain tentang jumble sentence, tentang procedure text, dan juga 4 soal ABC-an. Dikerjakannya itu sendiri-sendiri, tapi bisa diskusi dengan kelompok kalian masing-masing. Terus dikumpulkan ke saya kalau sudah selesai. Tugasnya apa? Membuat grup minimal
4.
Terus tugasnya ini individu apa kelompok?
Individu.
Ini. Iya. Oke, ini soalnya ya. I give you 15 minutes. Enough?
Enough.
Oke. Dimulai dari sekarang. Have you finished?
Yes.
Okay. Let's collect to me. Okay. Nah, karena waktunya sudah hampir habis, jadi tadi kita belajar tentang apa?
Procedure text.
Procedure text have structure. What is the structure of procedure text? Aim. And then
material.
And
steps or methods.
Okay, what is the purpose of procedure text?
Explain but how to do something.
Okay, great. And what's the language feature about procedure text?
Simple present
tense.
Connective.
Yeah. Imperative. Adverb of manner. Okay, great. Clap. Great.
Great. So great.
Tepuk tangan untuk kita semua. Okay, saya juga punya tugas daripada kalian nganggur ya di rumah. Saya punya tugas kalian membuat teks prosedur tentang cara membuat seblak atau nasi goreng yang biasa kalian buat. Terus juga tentang cara mengoperasikan sesuatu kayak tadi Zoom meeting atau siaran di Instagram. Seperti itu. Terus dikumpulkannya minggu depan di classroom. Oke, okay, understand?
Understand.
Tugas untuk minggu depan apa?
Membuat prosedur.
Tentang?
Terus?
Iya, yeah. Step to do something. Terus dikumpulkannya? Di? Okay, don't forget to review the lesson and keep spirit for your dreams. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Aku tidak mengerti aku ngomong apaan. Isinya banyak banget kan.
Jawab apa?
Kok nunjuk apa mamet ibu ya?
Iya ibu. Miki anak orang kaya ibu.
Sungguh kalau ini yang
mana? Isi. Tarik ya. Aduhnya mulus.
Dubis.
Kita pergi. Kau ada sih, angin ada sih. Terus ya.
Nyolong ke.
Ya, ya.
Bukti banget ya. Kayak orang masak. Orang kayak gue ke. Ini sih. Oke. Nah.
Pencet ora.
Coba.
Bentar mbak. Ini nopeng di sih kayaknya. Angel banget kak. Peng kau nulisin di peng. Perekaman. Ya, terus, Andi ngonku kia apa? Oke. Nyetelnya Cindy. Tengok orang jalan, Peng. No, Peng. Video ini orang jalan. Oh iya, Ding. Aduh.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning class.
Good morning.
How are you?
I'm fine.
Alhamdulillah I'm fine too. Right before we start our class, silakan ketua kelas untuk memimpin doa bersama. Mas Azib. Okay, thank you Mas Azib. Who is absent today?
No.
Oh, good.
Like anyone know today kita akan belajar tentang apa sih? Ada yang tahu nggak?
Enggak.
Nah, oke. Okay. Sebelum kita beralih ke materi hari ini, marilah kita menonton video ya. Guru punya video. Yuk kita lihat bersama. Oke, okay. Itu tadi video tentang apa? Ada yang tahu? Anyone know?
Berita.
Berita, right. Jadi, today we will learn about news item atau berita. Berita, ya. Next, definition of news item. News item is a text which inform readers about event of the day. Tadi news item itu apa ya? Teks yang menceritakan tentang kejadian atau berita pada hari itu. Okay. The event are considered newsworthy or important. It means if there is an important event that should be known by many people. And then social function. News item text aim to provide information to readers about an important event or event of value. Jadi fungsi dari news item itu apa sih?
Memberitakan.
Ya, memberitakan kepada seseorang tentang kejadian ya, suatu kejadian ya. And then generic structure. Ada berapa di sini?
Three.
Apa aja? Yang pertama?
Main event, elaboration,
okay, and the first is main event or newsworthy event. Main event is a paragraph that contains a summary of an event, as known as important event that is a highlight to be conveyed to the reader. Jadi main event itu ringkasan dari suatu kejadian ya. And then elaboration or background event. Background event contains the background of the event that occurred, starting from what and who was involved, where, when, why, and how the incident happened. Jadi di elaboration ini tuh mencakup kayak 5W1H ya, kayak apa, kenapa, bagaimana, mengapa, kapan, seperti itu. And then is the generic structure is the source of information. Source, which is the section that contains the opinion of expert or eyewitnesses. In addition, it can also be in the form of comments from various other parties involved. Jadi di research of information ini berisi kayak ada saksi mata yang melihat kejadian itu, kayak komen misalkan, tadi kejadiannya gimana ya Mbak, Mas, seperti itu. Paham ya?
Yes.
Oke. Next is language feature of news item. Ada berapa?
Four.
Yang pertama, using simple past tense. Yang kedua,
say verb.
Ya, yang ketiga,
use action verb.
And the last is
using adverb.
Ya. Language feature yang pertama, using simple past tense. Contohnya itu swollen river spilled over road. Jadi yang di bold itu termasuk kata simple past tense. Terus language feature yang kedua yaitu using saying verbs. Jadi using saying verb itu maksudnya kata kerja yang identik terjadi di aktivitas percakapan. Contohnya tuh kayak response, say, answer, ask, reply, inquire, tell, and so on. And the third is using action verb. Contohnya itu kayak sweeping away car and homes. And the last language feature is using adverb. Apa aja? Time, place, and then manner. Contoh dari time yang diput kata apa ya, Mbak Dwi?
Day of 46.
Yeah, day period from May 1 and June. And then place, Mbak Irma. Guangdong, ya. Yeah. And then manor, Mbak Salsa. Apa ya? Flooding caused by the
rain.
Okay, give applause to us. Jadi tadi apa aja ya language feature dari news item? Yang pertama?
Past tense.
Simple past tense, and then using saying verb, and then action verb, and the last is using adverbnya apa aja? Okay, good. Nah, this is example of news item and then structure textnya. Nah, itu coba dibaca Mbak Dwi kalimatnya.
9 people were killed, 1 injured in a helicopter crash on Wednesday.
Okay, thank you. Nah, itu tuh menceritakan apa di bagian dari news item, bagiannya itu main event ya, karena menceritakan kronologinya seperti itu. And then is
elaboration.
Ya, yeah, elaboration. Bisa dibaca Mbak Salsa kalimatnya?
The helicopter crashed near Manado on the northern side of the island of Sulawesi Thursday morning.
Oke, okay, itu termasuk bagian dari background event, kayak kayak kejadiannya tuh gimana, di mana, kapan, mengapa, seperti itu ya. Mencakup 5W1. Ya, tadi apa? Kalau elaboration itu mencakup 5W1H. Coba Mbak Andes, 5W1H itu apa aja?
What, where, who,
why, when, and okay, give applause to Mbak Andes. Okay, and then is research of information. Mas Novel bisa dibaca?
The helicopter was recovered by PT Nyaman
Air and Nyaman Air and
Pendensa Halmerendra. A joint venture between
Oke, okay, thank you Mas Novel. Ya, itu bagian dari research of information. Coba, tadi generic structure dari news item apa aja ya? Yang pertama? Main event or news story event. And the second one is? Or background event. Tadi background event itu mencakup apa?
5W1H.
Good. And the last generic structure is
research of information.
Good. Okay, next. Let's practice. Okay. Please make a group. One group consists 3 person. Okay. I will choose dari kalian ya. Kelompok pertama. Mas Dodo, Mas Azib, dan Mbak Laila. Kelompok yang kedua, Mbak Salsa, Mbak Dwi, dan Mbak Irma. Yang terakhir, Mbak Nida, Mbak Ade, dan Mas Novel ya. Silakan dibaca dulu. Baca dulu itu termasuk apa. Yuk. Finish. Ya. Silakan didiskusikan dengan kelompok kalian. Apa? Itu kan masih acak, silakan diurutkan teks itu berdasarkan structure ya, structure teks dari news item. Setelah itu coba cari gagasan utama dan informasi penting dari itu, dari teks tersebut. I will give you 5 minutes to work it. Enough?
No.
Okay. Finish guys? Ya. Yeah. Please collect to me. Okay. Ya. Kalian mau PR enggak? Mau ya? Ya, this is a homework untuk belajar di rumah ya, biar nanti kalian lebih paham ya tentang itu. Ini nanti dikumpulkan di pertemuan ke depan ya. Dikerjakan, itu di situ sudah ada soalnya. Oke? Okay? Bisa dipahami ya, guys? Oke. Okay. Tidak so far any question? Okay, if you no question, I think enough for me. Thank you and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Berapa menit?
Alah, beli udah yang belum lebih. Siapa lagi hari? Oh.
Ya, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, friend.
Good morning.
How about you? ulangi, Mbak. Ulangi. Ulangi. Enggak bisa. Ulangi lah. Bisa. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, class.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm fine. How are you?
I'm fine too. Thank you. Before we start our class today, let's pray together with saying basmalah together. I want checking attendance. Siapa yang enggak berangkat hari ini? Okay, good. Today we will learn about recon text. Nah, sebelum kita masuk ke materi recon text, I have one video about recon text. Okay, enough. Nah, di sini ada one example about recon text, yaitu berjudul Weekend at Dieng. Mas Aziz bisa reading this text. Okay, thank you, Mas Asyib. Nah, next, what do you know about recon text? Ada yang tahu recon text itu apa?
Enggak. Next to.
Mas Salsa?
Retail.
Okay.
Pastory.
Okay. Nah, yang pertama, definition of recon text. Nah, recon text is one type of text in English that contains story of an action or activity of the author or the character in the story. Jadi, recon text itu salah satu tipe teks di dalam bahasa Inggris yang menceritakan tentang aktivitas dari si sang penulis itu dalam bentuk cerita atau teks tulis. The next material is generic structure of free context. Di sini ada tiga. Yang pertama itu orientation. The first structure that contain information about the character, the place of the incident, when the incident took place, and so on. Jadi dalam orientasi itu menginformasikan tentang karakternya siapa aja, tempatnya itu di mana, kapan, dan yang lainnya. Terus yang kedua itu ada event. The second structure is the content of the text or in the form of stories about event or experience that the author wants to convey to the reader. Terus yang ketiga ada reorientation, yang berisikan conclusion atau kesimpulan dari informasi dalam text recount tersebut. The next material is characteristic of recount text. The first one is recount text using past tense. Yang kedua, recount text use part of speech adverb and adverbial to explain the time, place, and manner. For example, last October, Purbalingga, on the third day, and so on. Now the last one is recount text use part of speech conjunction and time connective to other event and even in the story to form a coherent script. Contoh, such as, and, after, the, that, before, and so on. Next, ada language feature. Di dalam recount text, terdapat language feature yang pertama itu adalah menggunakan personal participant seperti I, my, me, and so on. Terus yang kedua menggunakan chronological connection seperti first, then, third, and so on. Terus yang ketiga menggunakan linking verb seperti where, was, heard, saw, and so on. Yang keempat menggunakan action verb seperti go, look, change, run, and so on. Dan yang terakhir menggunakan simple past tense. Nah, saya kalian berkelompok, satu kelompok tiga orang. Saya kelompok satu, untuk itu ada Mas Asyib, Mbak Salsa, sama Mbak Lela Andes. Terus yang kelompok kedua itu ada Mbak Suhro, Mbak Dwi, sama Mbak Irma. Terus yang the last group itu ada Mbak Ade, Mbak Nita, sama Mas Noval. Di sini saya akan menyajikan satu teks recount. Kalian identifikasi bagian apa yang disebut dengan orientasi, event, and reorientation. 3 menit cukup ya. Oke. Dimulai dari sekarang. Enough?
Enough.
Oke. Saya kembalikan lagi ke saya. Satu lagi. Oke. Sampai di sini, apakah ada pertanyaan tentang recount text? Tadi kita belajar apa aja? Yang pertama itu generic structure, itu ada apa aja? Satu. Terus?
Event.
Ya.
Reorientation.
Nah. Terus, characteristic of recount text, Mas Azib. Apa aja tadi? Terus? Yang pertama itu ada using past tense. Oh. Terus yang kedua?
Using part of speech.
Ya.
The time,
terus yang ketiga?
Yang terakhir menggunakan part of speech connection and time connected to other events and events in the story to form a coherent script.
Okay. linguistic feature. Itu yang pertama tadi ada personal participant, chronological connection, linking verb, action verb, and the simple past tense. Nah, untuk tugas kalian untuk minggu depan, kalian membuat satu teks rekonteks tentang pengalaman kalian di masa lampau, singkat aja, nggak usah banyak-banyak, dan kalian identifikasi mana yang dinamakan orientasi, event, dan reorientation. Nah, sampai di sini apakah ada pertanyaan?
No.
No, oke. Okay. Mungkin maybe cukup dari saya. Kurang lebihnya mohon maaf. Billahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Lebih kurang ya? Ya enggak apa-apa.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning class.
Good morning.
How are you today?
I'm fine. How about you?
I'm fine too. Okay. Please, the chairman of the class lead our class praying together.
Okay.
Duduk siap, gerak. Gerak bulat. Besar.
Okay, who is absent today?
No.
No one. Okay, guys, people has many hopes and wishes in their life for their future dreams come true. Yeah. Badui, yes. What's your wishes for the future?
Be a success person.
Okay, Mbak Salsa?
Be a teacher.
Okay. Good. Now I have a paper that you should write down your hopes and wishes for your future. Okay? And then kalian simpan di buku kalian masing-masing harapan-harapan kalian untuk masa depan yang akan datang.
Okay.
Are you ready? Okay, I will give you 5 minutes. Enough?
Enough.
Okay. Have you finished, guys?
Yes, finished.
Okay. In this class, we will learn about wish or hope. Yeah. In bahasa is harapan, doa, dan juga keinginan yang ingin kita lakukan in the future. Okay, this one is the example dialogue, yeah, that expressing for hope and wishes. Anyone, can you read this for me?
Yes, yes.
Two people. Okay, Mbak Dwi and Mbak Sasa.
Hey, you look so down. Are you okay?
No, I'm not. My girlfriend is mad at me.
Hey, nobody.
I yelled at her yesterday. I'm good. I wish I hadn't gotten out of control like that.
Okay. Okay, give applause for Maddie and Basasa. Yeah, the example for dialogue one is include about expressing hope and wishes. Nah, the structure of hope and wishes is subject, wish, and someone rejection. Subject, this is for wish, yeah. Wish and someone, and for hope is subject, hope, and simple present. For example, subject, I wish you could help me. I wish you love her. I wish you can help me. Are you understand, guys?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
He wishes her good luck. He is subject. Okay. And wishes? Wish. And someone is? Her. Yeah. Think about hope. I hope Indonesia wins the World Cup someday. I is about?
Subject.
Hope and Indonesia is? Indonesia wins the World Cup someday. Simple? Give applause for Badwi. Okay. The next one is about example for the situation. For example, the situation, city has just made a very beautiful handicraft for pandan leaves. Benny praises her craft and hopes that she win the national crafts competition. And then Benny tell to city, Benny, that's a very beautiful handicraft. I'm sure you will win the national crafts competition. And city membalas si Benny, thank you, I hope so. Nah, berarti ungkapan hope-nya itu yang mana? Dari si
situation.
Ya. Are you understand, guys?
Yes.
You get it? Okay. The next is practice that you have to choose the best word to complete the conversation. Yeah. I will give you 15 minutes. This enough?
Enough.
Okay. Please you write the assignment in your book. Have you finished, guys?
Yes.
Okay, the last one is please make a group that consists two people and choose one of the feature, then make a dialogue according to the situation. Okay, this is picture for you for group 1, group 2, group 3, group 4, and group 5. Okay, I will give you 10 minutes. It is enough? Okay, please, after this, you should present your assignment and then watch the dialogue. Okay?
Okay.
Okay. Have you finished, guys?
Finished.
Okay. Siapa yang mau maju duluan? Okay, Mbak Ade and Mbak Layla. Time is yours. Please explain the situation and the dialogue.
Okay, situation 1, Tina has just got the result of her math test. She is waiting for the result of her English test.
Okay, give applause for two. Okay, so in this class we will learn about expressing.
How many is it?
Yeah. And then the structure is hope,
subject plus hope plus simple present.
Okay, grip, grip for baby. Okay, I think enough for me for this class. See you next week. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Kayak gerusa-gerusu banget tau. Iya apa? Gerusa-gerusu banget rasanya. Ngapain?
Nopeng, ngono yang mendi. Nopeng.
Apa?
Ngono yang mendi.
PPT-mu yang apa?
PPT-ne Irma.
Kenapa yang masih lain masih lebih pop? Orang kenapa gue kita pertama juga kita pertama nih kita pertama.
Ya. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Good morning, students.
Morning, friends.
How are you today?
I'm fine. How about you?
I'm good, thank you. Okay, before we start our learning activity today, let's start with saying basmalah together. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Okay, today is Sekarang tanggal berapa ya? Sekarang tanggal berapa?
9.
Tanggal 9 ya. Tanggal 9 bulan 9. Okay. Untuk hari ini kita belajar tentang apa yo? Nah, kita belajar tentang to in order to, so that agreeing and disagreeing. Okay, before I explain the material, kita akan lihat video berikut ini ya. Oke, silakan diperhatikan videonya ya. Nah, oke, udah lihat video yang pertama ya?
Yes, ma'am.
Nah, video yang pertama ini tentang apa ya?
Pesawat.
Yang pertama tentang apa ya tadi?
Tentang
apa?
Conjunction.
Conjunction. Okay. Sekarang kita lihat video yang kedua. Silakan perhatikan videonya ya.
Nah, oke, untuk video yang kedua tentang apa? Ada yang tahu?
Agree and disagree.
Oke, okay, agree and disagree. Good. Give a plus for us. Nah, jadi hari ini kita akan belajar tentang penggunaan conjunction, yaitu to, in order to, so that. Lalu ada apa lagi? Agreement and disagreeing. Oke, okay, good. Nah, ada percakapan nih. Saya pengen percakapan ini di kita collab ya, saya dan kalian semua, oke? Okay? Saya jadi Ismi, Sila kalian ya, nanti saya tunjuk. How if I change future? Coba Mbak Dwi.
Agree with your idea.
How if I change past? Mbak Salsa.
Disagree with your idea.
Okay, why should I change past? Mbak Lela.
In order to make your grandmother alive.
Okay, why should I learn ninjutsu? Mas Nopeng. Oke, jadi di sana kalian ada lihat kalimat agreeing and disagreeing nggak? Ada.
Ada.
Di bagian dialognya siapa?
Sila.
Sila. Gimana bunyinya?
Agreeing.
Iya. Oke. Yang conjunctionnya di bagian kalimat siapa?
Sila.
Sila lagi. Apa bunyinya? Apa?
In order to.
In order to. Oke, okay. Give a pause for us lagi. Nah, ini dia. Ini to ya. To itu berarti untuk, merujuk pada suatu tujuan, diikuti verb one. Examples-nya, we should eat breakfast to, untuk keep healthy. Oke. Okay? Yang kedua, ini in order to, dengan tujuan atau agar supaya digunakan. Biasanya ini digunakan, lebih sering digunakan di writing dan juga speaking ya, daripada speaking. Next, ada so that. Ini tuh sama, hampir sama kayak in order to, cuman ini menjelaskan dua kalimat sebab dan akibat ya. Seperti we should eat enough fruits and vegetables so that we will always healthy. You get it?
Yes.
Okay, good. Nah, ini tentang apa ya ini?
Agree and disagreeing.
Okay, yang pertama ada I agree with your statement. Kalimat agreeing yang mana?
I agree.
Okay, yang kedua ada absolutely right. Nah, yang kedua itu kalimat agreeingnya adalah absolutely. Yang ketiga, yes, Larry is right. Yang keempat, yes, that's
true.
Terus yang disagreeing, James, I'm not agree with your idea. Mana yang kalimat disagreeing?
I'm not agree.
Oke, okay, yang kedua, ketiga, dan empat. Dan ada questionnya juga, what do you think? How do you feel? Do you agree? Gitu ya. Jadi kalau kalian dalam suatu misal lagi kumpul sama teman, terus ada sebuah statement, kalian setuju, bilang setuju juga. Gimana caranya?
I agree.
Terus kalau misal nggak setuju?
I'm not disagree.
I'm not agree juga bisa. Tapi dengan alasan ya. Jangan langsung I'm not agree tapi tanpa alasan, oke? Okay? Be polite. Nah. Oke, okay, be ready to answer my question. Questionnya sederhana aja ya. Jadi dari tadi nih materi-materi yang tadi coba simpulkan ada apa aja. Siapa? Raise your hand. Oke, Mbak Lela coba. Oke, okay, good. Oke, okay, good.
So then, bermakna supaya.
Oke.
Okay. I agree, totally. And disagree, I'm not agree, I don't so.
Oke, okay, good. Give a plus buat Mbak Lela. Langsung saya beri nilai plus ya buat Mbak Lela.
Oke.
Oke. Get one, besok ya. Nah, ini ada fill in the blank lagi. Nah, fill in the blank nih. Ya, sekarang tanggal berapa ya?
9.
Tanggal 9. Saya pengen absen 9. Ada siapa ya? Mbak Dwi. Nih, where you go, Jack? I want to go to library, bla bla bla, find someone books for exam. Ini jawabannya ada di kotak. Yang mana, Mbak Dwi?
Two.
Okay, good. Give plus Mbak Dwi. Two itu artinya
untuk.
Untuk. Okay. Blank yang kedua. I must study hard. Sekarang tahun berapa?
2022
itu angka terakhirnya enggak berapa?
2.
Oke, okay, absen 2. Siapa? Mbak Zuhro. Oke. I must study hard
in order to get a good score.
Oke, okay, good. Give a plus Mbak Zuhro. Nah, jadi yang ketiga ini jawabannya adalah
so that.
Well, I want going library with you so that I can study with you, Jack. Okay, good. Nah, sekarang time to practice. Silakan kalian buat kelompok ya. Saya bagi kelompok aja ya. Jadi absen. Enggak usah pakai absen. Saya tunjuk aja. Kelompok pertama adalah Mas Noval, Mbak Dwi, Mbak Zuhro, Mbak Salsa. Kelompok kedua ada Mas Dodo, Mbak Lela, Mas Aziz, Mbak Ade, dan Mbak Nida. Oke, silakan diskusi. Kalian rangkum tentang materi yang tadi, ya. Silakan kalian berdiskusi dengan kelompok. Nanti habis itu ada praktis di depan. Silakan dipersiapkan, oke?
Oke.
Saya beri waktu 10 menit. Oke. Oke, udah selesai?
Ya.
Sekarang silakan yang mau maju untuk praktis. Siapa tunjuk tangan? Oke, silakan maju. Nah, sekarang silakan kalian berdialog tentang gambar ini. Coba seperti apa? Improving ya.
Ya. Do you agree with this picture? Absolutely agree. Okay. Do you agree with this trend? No.
Oke, okay, good. Silakan, terima kasih tepuk tangan Mbak Zuhro. Oke, okay. Sudah ya, tadi silakan kesimpulan yang kalian tulis dalam kelompok silakan disimpan untuk dijadikan portofolio. Dan ini adalah assignment, tolong ditulis, dikumpulkan minggu depan ya, dan juga dipraktekan, oke?
Okay? Oke, okay, Mas.
Oke, okay. I think our activity today is enough. This is the end of our meeting today. Thank you, jangan lupa kerjakan latihannya ya, dialog. See you next week. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.